agree on what the 21st century is.
Maybe.
I haven't asked for Trump, so I don't know. But the matter of defining Jewish art, of course, begins with the matter of defining art, and I would define it in two ways for our purposes. One, that art offers a kind of filter through which an artist reflects on and revisions and represents the world around him or her, his or her experience in the world. So one might define Jewish art, therefore, as part of Jewish experience, but you still haven't defined what Jewish experience is, so you still haven't defined Jewish art. You thought I was done, didn't you? Wrong. Art has also served throughout most of history, for thousands of years, as an instrument in the hands of religion, in offering a visual instrument with which to address the reality with which religion deals, which is a reality beyond our own, which is assumed to have some power vis-a-vis our own and therefore needs to be addressed. That's what religion does. And religion has various instruments, verbal, musical, movemental, but also visual, historically, at its disposal. And of course, some forms of what we would call, therefore, religious art, like Persian or Greek or Roman or Christian, deal necessarily in figurative terms, because the understanding of God in those forms of faith is as a figurative reality and therefore can be depicted figuratively. And as you all know, one of the assumptions for a long time regarding Jewish art is that it couldn't exist because Jews don't do art, because Jews don't do figures, because God can't be portrayed. And by now everyone knows how that's not true at all. At the very least, the discovery, as it were, of the Sarajevo Haggadah in the late 19th century, or even more so, the New Europa cycle of wall paintings in 1937 demonstrated unequivocally that at least in certain times and places, Jews have been perfectly comfortable, not only with visual representation, but with figurative representation, with human figures represented. So what is Jewish art? How does Jewish art relate to the idea of art as reflecting experience, art as serving as a means of addressing the other realm? What is Jewish? Is Judaism a religion? Is it a culture? Is it a body of customs and traditions? Is it a nation? Is it a civilization? Is it a people? All of those terms of phrase, of course, have been in play for the last two centuries, as we Jews and as the non-Jewish world has been so desperate to define and redefine us. Did I leave out ethnicity and race? Forgive me, Gilhelman, who reminds us that we're all Semites, and we're the only Semites, and that we're not Europeans. That's 1879. And if one speaks of Jewish anything, had I known how this morning was going to begin, of course, I would have changed my talk, and I'd be talking about Jewish cooking. After all, is challah Jewish? I mean, a twisted braided loaf, did that originate with Jews? How come the Moroccan Jews don't use it? How come Jews who come from the Middle, Eastern Europe do? Because, of course, it's a common way in which bread is made in Ukraine, Poland, and the like. So is it Jewish, or is it only Jewish when I use it to usher in Shabbat? So then it has nothing to do with the bread, does it, or of its interweave, but it has to do with the purpose to which it's being put. If I turn to Jewish art, then, am I talking, by the way, about the art? Am I talking about symbols, subject, style, content, intent, purpose, or am I talking about the artist? Oh, well, if the artist is Jewish, is Jewish art. What about someone who converts into or out of Judaism? Does that person's art suddenly become or cease to be Jewish? Does the Jewish artist have to have as his or her intention to make Jewish art in order for it to be Jewish? And by the way, historically, and not only conceptually, we have the question of Abraham, of course, having been called a Hebrew, and Moses an Israelite, and the same of King David, and Ezra's really a Judean. So Jewish anything is not Abraham, it's not Solomon's temple, although those are all essential, important, foundational elements in the edifice that becomes Judaism, and the edifice, therefore, of anything Jewish, including Jewish art. So my point to begin with is that we have a whole network of issues and problems, of questions of definition that have either difficult answers or perhaps no answers when we use the phrase Jewish art and try and understand it. If in historical terms I start for simplicity's sake with symbols, you all recognize, of course, this seven-branched candelabrum, the menorah, that appears on the underside of the Arch of Titus, built by his baby brother Domitian in the